The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. On those who live in a land of deep shadow, a light has shone. Indeed, it is the light of the world who comes into our world in order to redeem us all from the slavery of darkness to the sweetness of light. The Word became flesh in order to dwell among us. The Son of the living God, Christ Himself, takes up the form of a slave in order to identify Himself one with us, the suffering humanity. Christmas is a special time of grace, wherein the joy of the newborn King fills the face of the earth. On this great day of joy, as we celebrate the joy of the newborn King, we are called to radiate that joy to all those around us. The world today, more than ever, needs this joy of the Lord. Yes, this Christmas is not going to be the same for all of us. We all have faced so many challenges, so many difficulties, so many uncertainties during these hard times. COVID-19 has brought us all to a standstill. Though our celebration is not going to be the same, the birth of Christ our Lord and the joy He brings will be the same forever as always. He comes into our hearts. He comes into our homes. He keeps coming into our world. He makes Himself incarnate in and through the ordinary events of our everyday life. Indeed, this deeper realization is what we all need during this difficult time in order to celebrate the joy of Christmas in the midst of all these uncertainties prevailing on this planet. We are called to recognize God incarnate, becoming flesh and blood in the ordinary events of our life. The more we recognize Him, the merrier we become in our life, and all the more we will be able to radiate that joy to all those around us. Let our innermost longing, dear friends, to celebrate the joy of Christ continue to echo in our hearts as we recall the beautiful words of the great poet Rabindranath Tagore. Have you not heard His silent steps? He comes, ever comes. Every moment and every age, every day and every night He comes, comes, ever comes. Many a song have I sung, in many a mood of mine, but all their notes have always proclaimed, He comes, comes, ever comes. In the fragrant days of sunny April, through the forest path, He comes, comes, ever comes. In the rainy gloom of July nights, on the thundering chariot of clouds, He comes, comes, ever comes. In sorrow after sorrow, it is His steps that press upon my heart, and it is the golden touch of His feet that makes my joy to shine. He comes, comes, ever comes. Even in the midst of COVID-19 pandemic, He comes, He ever comes in order to make our joy complete. As we celebrate His birth, can we take efforts just like Him to identify ourselves one with the suffering humanity? Can we identify ourselves with those human rights defenders languishing in the jail? Can we identify ourselves with those poor farmers protecting for our rights and the rights of our future generation? Can we identify ourselves with the poor and marginalized of our world whose fundamental and innermost human dignity are violated? Can we identify ourselves with the last and the least in our society in order to make God incarnate manifest in their lives? If we spread at least an iota of goodness, surely we will make the radiance of the eternal light shine upon this world. As I wish you all a Merry Christmas, I invoke the Lord Jesus, who is born for us, the eternal King, to come into our hearts and to fill our homes with abundance of His joy, His peace, health and prosperity. Morning Star, radiance of eternal light, Son of Justice, come. Come to enlighten those who live in darkness and in the shadow of death. Wish you all a Merry Christmas. Thank you.